systems that are a factor of how humans think and work, why reinvent those? We can't change the human being themselves, you know? And there's a reason things have been organized in a certain way. So let's not try to go into the study of sociology and like start psychology and psychiatry and try to figure out, okay, how do we do it? There are existing models, let's take those. So one of the things that we've noticed is that these diasporas have political structures, and they go all the way up. They start at local levels, state levels, they go all the way up. They start from school commissions and commissioners, planning commissioners, even below that. You know, they have delegates for, you know, electoral college. Many, many levels, because sometimes I think when we want to get active, we go, let's put somebody in the Congress. That's not necessarily your first step. So there's a whole political structure, hierarchy, that you can climb. Then there's a whole business structure that you can climb. And I think we have been integrated fantastically from a business standpoint into the American economy, but not as networked together. So it's wonderful when I see Iranian American Bar Association, Iranian American Medical Association, et cetera. I think that's terrific. And if those something like that could grow into a tie, it would be amazing. Imagine the kind of mentoring that goes on at Thai. I mean, and they get anybody from India to come here speak. It's a very powerful organization. Go look it up. It's astonishing. So there's a whole business infrastructure. And then there is the cultural and philanthropic infrastructure. And that's where we hope to help, by being a community foundation, help other people sort of build and deliver. Because we don't want to be program deliverers necessarily. We want to essentially raise money to be able to help other people grow. So let's take what we've learned from other people, let's apply it, and let's put all our effort not in rethinking, you know, existential questions, but let's execute on what we can learn from other people.
And what's incredible is how each of you have contributed to doing that over the last 4 years and how far you've come, granting over $1 million from what I understand. And just coming together as a community to do it, building on the lessons that have been learned from so many other communities before you. So thank you so much, Nishina, and congratulations.